What is up, good healthy people, my beautiful healthy people? It's Elmira, always helping you become a self-care boss. As you can see, I am out here early today. It is almost 6 a.m. about to get my workout in, go to my workout class and join some tunes before I go inside. But I had this thought. It is about, what is blocking your storage? What is taking up your storage space? I actually had an experience this morning which brought me to this. I actually went to bed early last night, which meant I got up before midnight, and that means every time I do that, I end up just staying up. And I got a lot of stuff accomplished. And those wee hours of the morning, you can do a lot of thinking, planning. It is actually the most creative time for me. Like, I can write songs and poetry and all of that. But what's blocking your storage? Here's what occurred. My phone had been running low on storage, and I'm like, I need to clean some stuff up. Some of this stuff has got to go. So I have been deleting pictures and all of this. And then I took a look at my apps. Oh my gosh, look how beautiful that is out there. Y'all, God's creation is amazing. Look at that. If you never, I mean, those are the lights right there, but the clouds come. Oh, I just love, love, love. You just got to appreciate the simple things. You got to please appreciate those simple things. But here goes. I was like, what is taking up all of my storage? Do you know the Facebook app was taking up about 6 to 7 megs or gigs of my storage? When I cleaned that out, I was able to free up 20% of the space on my phone. I was like, what the heck? And then I related it back to this. You know, last year I did an entire year social media fast. I was not on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, any of that. But what I discovered was I lessened my dependence on Facebook, but I found myself this year slipping back into it. And that's my message for today. It was taking up storage, plus Facebook was taking up too much time in my life. I'm like, what am I really doing? Keeping up with this noise, keeping up with these people that I really don't care about, posting and responding and commenting. I deleted it. I deleted the entire app today. I had already, earlier this year when I got back on, I had turned off the comments anyway, so I wasn't getting all of those constant and rapid notifications about what was going on. But today, I let it go. And I came to the realization, because I only had it on there because from time to time, I do live videos to teach, do the same thing I do here. And I just said, you know what? I don't need it anymore. I'm going to refocus, because that was taking up space in my heart. It was taking up time that I should be working on my purpose. I should be working on my music, and it's occupying space. My question for you, what is occupying that valuable space in your life, that valuable space in your body, that valuable space in your heart, that valuable space in your home? You're not able to make room for something else, much like my phone. I couldn't make any room for new memories, for new things, for new sharing, because I had damn Facebook blocking up all of my space, storage space. And y'all know I ain't getting a new phone, but it was blocking my space. What is taking up the storage in your life? There is something occupying valuable real estate, I shall call it. Something is taking up valuable real estate because you can't make room for nothing new. I had to make some time to do my music. I have been neglecting my creating music and even going to perform. Like, I went to karaoke the other night and did that, but I know I can push harder with my singing. Y'all know I love music. Like, I love, that's all I've ever done. Like, throughout my life, that's all I've done. Singing and talent shows and creating my own music, recording album and songs, and just, you know, I sung at church. It's like, that's what I love to do, because things were blocking up time and I allowed it to. That's the thing with being a self-care boss. You got to recognize what's occupying your time and switch. Just make a move. One day you may wake up and say, okay, I'm making a change in my life. And nobody else has to force you to make the change. You recognize the need for the change yourself and do it. That's what I'm doing. I'm dedicating, you know, these upcoming weeks to me working on my music instead of worried about other people's lives, because that's really and truly what I was doing. And I found myself digging deeper and deeper into that hole. And I'm like, Elmire, why are you doing this? This don't even make no sense. You know, this ain't where you want to be. Shift. Make a change. Are you going to shift? Are you going to make a change? Is something taking up the storage in your life and you need to dump it? You know how that storage unit, you know, you got all this old stuff in the storage unit. You've been paying $100 a month for the past 5 years. That stuff you haven't even accessed. You haven't even went to it. You don't need the damn stuff. So why are you still holding on to it? That's my message to myself and my message to you. What is taking up the storage in your life and you know you don't need it anymore? My lesson this morning was Facebook. I deleted it. It was occupying too much room on my phone and too much room in my life. Remember, you can book your massage with me at couturemassage.com. Additionally, purchase one of my ebooks. First one I wrote is Becoming a Self-Care Boss, 31 Days to Self-Discovery. Second ebook is Hi Bye, I'm Too Shy, An Introvert's Guide to Networking. Until next time, my beautiful, healthy people, y'all make it a relaxing day and clean up the storage. Clean up the storage. Okay, bye.